Welcome to Art for Film's Sake. I'm Stephen Reed, and this is The Godfather by Sean Phillips.
I believe in America. America has made my fortune.
The American dream. It really does come true. And for Amerigo Bonasera, a humble Italian immigrant, it did. Until it didn't. The America that served him so well failed him when he needed it the most. One night, his daughter is brutally attacked and left scarred for life. So he went to the authorities for help.
I went to the police like a good American.
But the American justice system lets the perpetrators walk free. Filled with rage, he is forced to seek justice from a place he always wanted to avoid.
For justice, we must go to Don Corleone.
The opening scene for Francis Ford Coppola's The Godfather is a flawless example of how to establish a plot. In just a short few minutes, it gives us everything we need to know about the world we are about to enter. It's fitting then that Sean Phillips has chosen to place it firmly at the heart of this brilliant poster. Because Bonasera's meeting with Don Corleone says so much of what The Godfather is all about. The very purpose and existence of the Italian mob. An organisation that exists as an underground economy and society for people who feel left out or let down by the established one. So here we see Bonasera with his back to us, hunched over the desk, a posture that tells us he'll do anything to get his revenge. If the law won't punish his daughter's attackers, then he'll make sure someone will. Someone like the Godfather. The star attraction is, of course, Marlon Brando, superbly rendered and rightly center of our attention as he listens to Bonasera's plea. Phillips has skillfully invited us into the meeting, at a respectful distance, of course. We are the audience, enthralled by the theatre playing out in front of us. Crucially, the supporting cast of Corleone's consigliere, Tom Hagen, and his eldest son, Sonny, are also present. Phillips has placed them in the shadows, but not just as mere extras. The menace of their presence is in fact amplified by it. It tells us that they are more important than that. Phillips is showing us that, as Corleone's right-hand men, they are indeed key players in the story. But it's the lighting that makes it clear who's in charge here. The Godfather himself. The light shines down on him as he sits, stroking his cat, patiently listening and waiting for his moment. Corleone knows that when the American dream inevitably lets someone down, it's him they turn to. And once you owe the Godfather a favour, you'll never be free. He knows the gaps he can fill in order to justify his presence and existence in American society. When there's an opportunity to reinforce his power and influence, he won't hesitate. And Phillips doesn't employ subtlety to bring this to life either. he uses that iconic New York City skyline as a manifestation of the American dream and puts it right there at the top of the composition. Its significance is impossible for us to ignore. The iconic buildings loom majestically above, whilst the Godfather waits below. It's a simple but powerful conceit that Phillips has conjured up here. What we have is an artist drawing on his skill and expertise in one creative field and applying them to another. His years of creating amazing comic books have been effortlessly transferred into the confines of the canvas he's been given to great effect. This poster is showing us in no uncertain terms that if the American dream doesn't serve the Italian-American community, Don Corleone will catch them as they fall. This is something Bonasera knows. He tried to be a good American initially, but in the end, his desire for justice has left him no alternative but turn to the mob. He's fallen into the trap. But then you look at that skyline again and realise that there's more to it. Something else is going on here. Phillips has mirrored it, flipped it upside down. Placed together like that, it takes on a different form and meaning. Those soaring skyscrapers, symbols of ambition and wealth, become spiky instruments of death and despair. Pointing down, ready to pierce those protagonists below. Because in truth, they are all trapped. Not just Bonasera and others like him, but the mafioso too. There's no escape for any of them. They'll either end up in prison or end up brutally dead. One day, the American dream will catch up with all of them. Even the Godfather himself.
How did things ever get so far? I don't know.
When you look upon this magnificent poster, you know all right. You can see it playing out right in front of you. A theatre in your own home. And what a show it is. Thank you.